Frankie Capone did a talent on the Wolverine Council, taking on the entire Capone family, unfortunately for him single-handedly, but he comes back to IPW Hardcore Wrestling, and right away, gets in line for a shot at IPW Television Champion, the Miami Paw Machine, Rod Steele.
I love when Rod does that with the belt, but let's face it, Frankie set himself up for this match before he ever lost for Puerto Rico. Jet Jaguar and Rod Steele were going tooth and nail in an IPW Television title match. Frankie Capone comes out mad that he never gets the television title shot, hits Bumpin' in the head with a chair, and he got exactly what he wanted. He's going for the gold IPW Television title.
Neither one of these competitors wasting any time whatsoever. This is for the IPW TV title. This is for one of the most coveted titles in the entire business. Rod Steele rips off his shirt, goes right to the outside. He's going to take it to Frankie Capone any way he can.
And he's taking it to Pete Cannon and Mark Gold, slinking off in the background. Very, very smart. Mark Gold wants to prove that when he led Agent Steele to the IPW heavyweight title, only to be unceremoniously dumped for Tiffany, who, by the way, he tells me he broke Tiffany in. He told me straight up he was mine before she was his.
When you say he broke her in, what exactly are you saying, Aaron?
Everybody knows what I'm talking about when he says he broke her in. But more to the point, he wants to prove he's the manager of champions, and he's trying to come out here and lead Frankie Capone to this television title. And there you see Frankie Capone holding him up British Bulldog style. Oh, drop Rod Steele right on his back.
Huge vertical suplex by Frankie Capone. Nonchalantly covers, if I can use the term loosely.
And Rod Steele kicks out after Frankie Capone gets up. That's just instincts kicking in there.
Did somebody just open the door in the back, or was that the joints of Star Stevens creaking? Obviously, he didn't apply the bent gate gingerly to his knees and to elbows like he does before every competition.
I don't know about Star Stevens, but I do know Frankie Capone just drop-kicking Rod Steele in the back. Maybe he got that in Puerto Rico, and Mark Gold trying to get involved again, but Rod Steele able to back away. Tell you what, Rod Steele seems to be the fan favorite in this match against the likes of Frankie Capone. Very unusual for Rod Steele to be cheered by the fans, but we've said it before and we'll say it again. People at IPW are fans. They cheer talent, and Rod Steele has talent in bunches.
Rod Steele has taken up with the tradition which started right here in IPW. He is the television champion. He demands that he defends the title right here on IPW Hardcore Recap. He doesn't care if it's against Frankie Capone. He doesn't care if he's in there with Jet Jaguar. He doesn't care if he's in there with the former champion, Dr. Heresy. This is the television champion doing what he does best.
Frankie Capone rips Rod Steele into the rope. Oh, and he kicks him right in the face. Kicks him right in the face again. Rod Steele gets the second win. Oh, is he going to get the... Oh, I don't know if he's going to get the three count because the editing truck just cut to another clip.
Unbelievable. Obviously, the editing truck doesn't know what's going on. Rod Steele with a huge springboard cross body block, Luthez style, hits Frankie Capone, got him for 2.5 count, but because of time constraints, we had to cut to this segment where, once again, Frankie Capone is taking over on the offense. Is Frankie Capone in charge of the production here, Aaron Royal?
Frankie Capone is in charge of anything Frankie Capone wants to be in charge of. He was choking out Rod Steele. Now he's hitting him with elbows in the back of the head. Rod Steele has taken on anybody and everybody for that title, but Frankie Capone has given him more than he can handle right now.
You talk about the history of this television title, but let's hit on another point. Frankie Capone, taken under the wing by Ricky Santana in Puerto Rico, went down to the World Wrestling Council and run roughshod over the entire Colon family. And the referee of choice tonight, the Mud Baby Star Stevens, knows all about the World Wrestling Council, knows all about Puerto Rico because of the dreaded Mud Match of 1978.
Big, big Mud Match, and Frankie Capone just does a big drop in Rod Steele on his back right there. Rod Steele in a lot of trouble. Maybe he's done too much color commentating and playing with the ladies instead of preparing for Frankie Capone.
Let's call a spade a spade. What is Frankie Capone thinking when he's got an easy, again, he's got a chance to win this title. He's nonchalantly covering him. He's not hooking the legs. He's not doing everything he can to get that lateral press for the three count. And now he's in the corner. He's taking his time arguing with Star Stevens, and Rod Steele sees the opportunity, and he mounts a comeback of his own.
Rod Steele, you can never count him out. Getting second, maybe even third win by now, and just does an inverted neck breaker kind of maneuver there. Everybody knows I can't call moves. I'm just here to be the host. I should be the color commentator.
That was a fisherman's neck breaker.
Exactly what I just said.
I think it was anyway. Actually, I'm just making it up. But you see Cannon over in the corner doing what he does best, and that's unfortunately distracting the referee, Mud Baby Star Stevens. Tell him he's got a dime bag over there for the mere price of $17.50.
And Rod Steele swinging at Pete Cannon, allowing Frankie Capone to come back in. Oh, I thought it was a three count right there. I thought we had a new television champion. But Rod Steele should showing the intestinal fortitude that has got him this far in a short 2 years, able to kick out just in time.
Rod Steele is going to do everything he can, like I said earlier, against Frankie Capone. Why the fans are cheering for him, I don't know. Maybe it's because he's one of the most colorful personalities here at IPW. Maybe it's because he's the most competitive IPW television champion I can remember. Look at the unbelievable athletic ability of Rod Steele, only to be cut off once again by Pete Cannon.
And this isn't a no DQ match, and there you go. Star Stevens throwing this match out as Pete Cannon stomping all over Rod Steele. I hate to see what's going to happen when Double Deuce gets all over the television champion right now.
I have to question the motives and the game plan of Frankie Capone here. He may have been down, but I don't believe he was out. He had a legitimate shot at still winning that television title, but he calls in the reinforcements. He calls in Mark Gold, he calls in Cannon, and that brings up the madman himself, Jaguar, master of the Irish Hammer, who lays out Pete Cannon and Frankie Capone with wicked steel chair shots.
I don't know what people were talking about. It looked to me like he was swinging that chair at their head just fine. He's missing a little bit, going crazy. I'm waiting for him to dance. I'm waiting for him to bump and pop around like nobody's business, like he always does. And what's he get? Oh, and he lays out Rod Steele. Rod Steele thought he had a friend. You took out Jet Jaguar's knee. He's no friend of yours, Rod Steele.
I manage Jet Jaguar. He's one of the charter members of 911 Incorporated. I go back going over my game plan with the rest of my organization. Jet Jaguar takes matters into his own hands. He grabs a steel chair. He comes in and lets know Jet Jaguar is still in IPW, and Steve Hill will get a shot at that television title, Aaron Royal.
Way dance in the future, Ron Neamey.
Jet Jaguar, the former Cruiserweight champion, four times over.
Five.
Five times over? I manage a guy and I don't even know. He's making his presence known in the IPW television title hunt. They talk about the hardcore title when they talk about the madness and the sickness, but the IP spot machine. But you want to talk about high spots? Naphtali, the Florida Unified Cruiserweight champion, and Jerrelle Clark.